During the VO2 max test, we also measured blood lactate values in our athletes at every stage. The graded exercise test gets harder and harder every few minutes, and what we see is also a gradual rise in blood lactate levels as the intensity increased. About midway or two-thirds of the way through the test, the lactate levels jumped up and suddenly increased at a much higher rate. This sudden increase in blood lactate levels is termed the lactate threshold. This is a really interesting threshold for athletes to understand within their body because it serves as an indicator of that threshold between sustainable versus unsustainable exercise for a prolonged period of time. An athlete who trains or races with a heart rate monitor can use that threshold as a guide for pacing during an event. So for example, if you know your lactate threshold occurs at a heart rate of about 165 beats per minute, then for a race event, if you shot off the starting line and your heart rate's going at about 182 beats per minute, that's a clear indication to pull back a little bit. You're probably starting out too fast. Similarly, if you started and your heart rate's cruising along at 155, perhaps that's an indication that you can push a little bit faster. With training, the lactate threshold can be pushed to a higher intensity, so it can be pushed to a higher percentage of VO2 max. Oftentimes we see a range of untrained individuals, their lactate threshold occurs at around 50 to 55% of their VO2 max. A highly endurance trained athlete may have a lactate threshold that occurs at about 80 to 85% of their VO2 max. This equates to a faster, sustainable pace for an endurance event.
We're taking a look at lactate threshold not as a single point on a curve, but a range of points. It's where the body begins to accumulate lactic acid above a resting level and peaks when your body can no longer process the lactic acid that's being produced. Being equipped with these numbers allows me to work with my coach and establish specific training programs and blocks of training. My goal in training with lactate is to move that lactate threshold range further up the curve.